there's something about when we did the stakeholder event, mapping the amount of advice and support that was out there for people. There's a lot of it there, but equally not everybody knows where it is and how to access it. So I think it's a job about helping people and raising awareness of what is there to support people and tackling the other. The third thing around tackling you need impacts of poverty. These are the things like, can you afford food, can you afford to eat food, the policy around poor housing, and the consequences of poor health. Those are things that are immediate, they're not long term, they're things that people are dealing with right now. So it's about how can we actually mitigate some of those through the work that we do in partnership. And we've heard earlier about housing, and that was particularly around extra care housing, but our housing strategy understanding how we create positive environments for people. And I know there's been a lot of work over the last couple of years around affordable warmth, about homes being insulated, all those kind of things that help people with things like fear and oxygen. The final thing is, again, about supporting parents into sustainable employment, because recognising that people cannot work, there's still an acceptance, I think, that the best way to move out of poverty is about tackling the barriers to people gaining employment. And I think we're really keen to find ways in which we can harness resources without being able to do so. And so we want to work very much with those developing the growth strategy, those working in the chamber, as I've mentioned before, local businesses to understand what opportunities we can provide people, working with college, talking about the skills somebody needs, helping people get the qualifications that will enable them to be able to take up the opportunities that exist in the world. So there'll be some key strands of work around that. And really, one aspect of that is about working with our transport partners as well, to enable people to get to those opportunities, because people need to be able to travel around, and sometimes that can be a barrier. So how do we work there? So I think today we've come up with those four key themes that we know the methods, we know what people told us, but we've been really focus our energies in terms of improving life chances. We want to see a reduction in the number of children and families living in poverty from the poverty baseline. We'd like to see reduced unemployment. We'd like to see that increase in attainment. And we'd like to see increased uptake of entitlements and those things that can benefit people if they are. That will be challenging, and this is a 5-year strategy, so we need to recognise that in terms of confidence. I think the key next steps really now is we want to do a bit more insight work, because we've done some surface insight. I think we need to get underneath some of these issues and understand them better to be able to respond to them. We want to think about innovative solutions. Those themes, we need owners for those themes to take them forward. And it's very much about using the resources that we already have in the world to take those forward as well. And make sure that we do strengthen those links between this strategy and the other strategies that I've mentioned to make sure there's joined up. So we don't have separate ambitions in each strategy, but if there's a clear line of sight between what we want to achieve here and what's in the strategies around children and women for work or employment or in the housing strategy itself. So we're moving on now, hopefully, to working to pull together groups, task groups, to help us come up with some of those solutions. We're looking very much at the working group to give us some steering and engagement with them on that one as well.
Thank you very much, David. Questions for
Thanks, Chair. Thanks, Chair. That was really, really interesting. That's myself, because I keep thinking we're the fifth richest country in the world, and yet we're talking about this tonight. How we got so badly wrong, really, but also the council that we have as a society. I'm concerned about welfare reforms that are coming our way, because we know that the cut to tax credits is simply going to be repackaged into universal credit, we know that. And I think there's also going to be changes around the SA, so the bad people disappear. People will be forced either to claim job seekers and look for work who aren't ready to do that, or be sanctioned basically, and that's going to, it's just going to impact even further. So I was wondering, had you factored that in, or if that just, it seems to be an ongoing activity we've not known from our pattern, it's impact on that.
Inevitably, national policy impacts on all our work, and we need to understand those impacts and how they will fall and where they fall so that we're able to respond appropriately. Certainly, I think in the stakeholder discussions, a lot of the agencies involved in supporting people are learning and are very conscious of changes in the way benefits are some of the issues that you mentioned. It is really about those who are knowledgeable, but we are at the mercy in some way of being able to, you know, what we're able to do in terms of that. There's something about, I remember some people say we can't necessarily control what happens to you, but we can think about our response to it. And I think what we have here is an opportunity to think about our response at the local level to these issues.
David.
Thank you, Fiona. You'll forgive me because I always think that when you use emotive words like poverty, you should always probably define what you understand it to be. And I'm just curious if there's two sort of points with it. One is what your definition of poverty is, because I'm not entirely sure that everybody in the room is on the same page. And I think the other one is, I do know that there are some... Sorry, David. No. And I think there are some people who possibly... who I do know who earn what is perceived, just as an example, by Bernardo's as below the poverty line, wouldn't describe themselves as in poverty. Now, Bernardo seems to describe it as that after you had all your housing paid for, you have £375 a week left. Is that your definition of poverty?
The definition that the groups decided to use are a number of definitions of poverty. What we've agreed is, we work to the definition of children are defined as living in relative poverty if their household income is less than 60% of the median national income.
Right.
So the median income is a middle line between the highest and local incomes, the lowest incomes in the country. So if you take the median, so if they are at 60% less than the average, the median, and that apparently is the most widely used definition. So that's the one we have chosen. That's the one where I would accept there are other definitions.
Yeah, no, forgive me. I genuinely didn't know the answer to the question. It's just that it's interesting that Bernardo defines it almost as though it's the just below the sort of average UK salary of about 26,000. Yet you're defined at a much lower level, so therefore your percentage is always going to be higher. Have I missed something there? Please don't use emotive language like that. I would like a definition of what you believe poverty is.
The definition is based on national definition, so it's not a local definition.
Is that a government definition?
They are reviewing their definition. One of the reasons we change it to improving life chances is because people don't like being described as in a very negative way. But on the other hand, when your income is very low, it has an impact on the chances you have in life. So it is important to recognise that.
Thank you.
funny enough, as we can do in the strategy, that's absolutely what we've been talking about, is the right way to go. Because there are some things we can affect and there are some things we can't, but we can absolutely help people to move forward.
I just do want to make a comment, because one of the first things I wrote down as you started your presentation there, Fiona, was people don't like being called poor. And I understand that people don't like being called poor, but if you use other expressions or words to define having insufficient to live on, insufficient to grow, and insufficient to develop properly, then you are not doing people any favours. So to say, a bit hard up, all that sort of thing, all those words have been developed because people find the fact that there are people in this country, and I'm not saying it's a new problem, but it's very acute at the moment, who are poor, they find that very uncomfortable to understand. And I'll leave it at that now. So thank you very much for your presentation. Right, move on to item 11. And positive forward, you have to look short of this, it's really for note. Okay, you have to know that. And the highlight of we are a little pro gathering evidence on the ability of efficient scrutiny review, and that's going very well. We've got a few more sessions penciled in, and we're hoping to finish that by the end of February. We have the budget scrutiny workshop, which was held on the 11th of January. I think that was fairly successful and well attended, and I think it was useful for people. The report from that, which will be a chair's report, will go to the coordinating committee on the 16th of February, but I intend to circulate that to members of the committee who are present participants at the scrutiny workshop in advance, just so you can see what I have written. It will be, I hope, and that's about what I've been doing. It will be an accurate reflection of the comments that were made at that time, but I will circulate that in advance. We've got a focus on session with the Rural Community Trust on the 17th of February, and we know that CQC gave Rural Cheshire Partnership Trust a good inspection report, but we're here for detail of that and the helping her panel. I'm going to ask if people want to make suggestions for further work, and I know Councillor Brightmore would like to make a suggestion.
Thank you, Chair. Monster, you're acting for us.